We've taken a look at how to create document types, content nodes, and templates to set up and configure an Umraku project. In order to get familiar with how things work, let's repeat the process. In this video, we'll expand our project by creating more document types, content, and templates. So, let's go. We'll start by creating a generic content page. We'll go to Settings and right-click the Document Types folder and select Document Type with Template. I'll cover the rest of the options in the coming videos. We'll call our document type Content Page. And let's give it an icon. So we'll select Page Icon. There we go. And add our description. This is a simple content page. Moving on, we'll add a group called Content and add a single property called Body Text and select the Rich Text Editor and submit the property and save the document type. Now, we'll go ahead and set up the template. I have the HTML files from the Custom Umraku Template folder open here in Visual Studio Code. I'll use the one called ContentPageSimple.html. From here, I'll copy the content only from the main container section and go back to the back office. In the Templates folder, I'll go to the Content page and below the Razor Code block, I'll paste the HTML code. Cool. We need to make sure that our template is using the master template. And for the dynamic values, I remove the content between the div class container tags and insert the body text value and save the template. As we can see, the content page template is now nested under the master template over here in the tree. Let's go ahead and create some content page using this document type. In the content section, we'll click on the three dots next to the welcome page. There's a message that says there are no allowed document types available for creating content here. So first we need to allow for this type of content to be created under content using the homepage document type. Let's do as it says here. We'll go to the settings section and go to the homepage document type. We'll go to the permissions tab and in the allowed child node types, we can configure which type of content should be allowed to be created as child nodes. So we'll select add child and choose our content page document type. Let's save the document type and head back to the content section. Now, if we click on the three dots next to the welcome page, it allows us to create a content page. So let's go ahead and create the node. Let's call it About Umraku. And for the body text, I'll just add some content and an image. All right, let's save and publish our content node. It is now nested under the welcome page here in the content tree. Great, let's check out the front end. We'll click on the info tab and click on the link to the publish page. There it is. So this is how a simple content page looks like. It contains the navigation bar, the banner with the title and the subtitle, the body text value in the middle and the footer text at the end. I'll now go ahead and add the contact us page as well. All right, I've now created the contact us page. So let's take a look at the elements I've added. The document type is quite simple at the moment. It consists of a body text with a rich text property editor. In the home page, I've set the document type permissions to include the contact us page as child nodes in the allowed child node types. Moving on to the template, The template is nested under the master template. I've taken the structure from the contact page HTML from the custom Umrako template folder. I've left the contact form here as it is and rendered out the body text property here. Now it's time to head over to the content section. Under the welcome node, I've created a contact us page. I've filled in some information in the body text property. I've also added few more simple content pages. Let's take a look at the front end of the contact us page. As we can see, the template is the same across the home page and the contact us page. You might also notice that the title and the subtitle are static. They are the same on both the pages. So, if we look at the contact us page, it says Welcome Umrako TV. And if we look at the About Umrako page, it's exactly the same, even though these pages are based on two different document types. To fix this, we'll need to use a feature called Compositions, which we'll look at in the next video. And that's it for this video. See you in the next one.